Well, I was born with missing tibias in both of my legs, and my feet were twisted all the way around. So the doctors gave my mom the choice of either putting me in a wheelchair or having my legs amputated. And she opted to have them amputated, so I became a double above knee amputee. Grew up in San Diego, California, until I was about 12, 13 years old. Moved to Birmingham, got introduced to CRS, got more involved and started, I guess, learning more and knowing that my disability doesn't necessarily have to hinder me or hinder what I do. I believe stuff like the clinics with CRS definitely helped me out. I met other families with other children in the same situation. We both would learn from each other. It helped me. I think one thing it really helped me with is the way I walk on my prosthetics. I noticed when I was younger, I was kind of wide stepping, and working with CRS, I kind of straightened my stride out a little bit. They know how to work with somebody with a disability. They were never too forceful on me to do something or too laid back. They always pushed me enough to figure out what I needed. I was afraid of the water. So learning how to swim was just to overcome my fear. And once I overcame it, I basically said, I want to do this, as a sport. I want to train and get faster and compete. I went to the 2012 Paralympic trials. I didn't make it then, but I'm training for now for the 2016 Paralympic trials. And right now it's looking like it's possible. But, I'm interested in more than just physical activity, I guess. I honestly love school right now. I think the more and more I got into my major classes, the more I was interested in what I was learning. I know going through the college prep courses and with voc rehab paying for my college tuition and books, I know for me and my mom, we had tough living situations growing up. That's why we left California, because we ended up, being homeless out there. So I think it was definitely very beneficial to have voc rehab and everyone helping us out. I try to tell other people that your disability doesn't have to stop you from doing what you want to do, We were talking about, what did you want to be what did you want to do for a career? And I thought about just what I like to do, and it was always something with sports in high school, I always got in trouble for talking, so I always told myself I could do a job where all I had to do was talk. And so I thought about motivational speaking, because I definitely like reaching out to the younger generation. The main thing I would like to share through motivational speaking is the mindset can change the whole situation. Telling younger kids if they want to go to college, they can go to college. If you want to be the president, you can be the president, And telling people with physical disabilities that, look at me, there's nothing stopping me, so there shouldn't be anything stopping you. ADRS to me means having a normal life, not living and worrying about my disability. Just going day by day, living the life I want to live. It's crazy thinking about where I could have ended up, college to me at one point was not even an option, because I knew we couldn't afford it. And I know if I didn't have, that type of growing up situation with CRS, then I definitely don't think I'll see myself being the way I am today.